with me.
Taught
me how to shoot hoops.
Hold on 1 second. Hold on. Hello?
Mr. Kurt.
Hey.
I'm here, man.
All right, here I come.
All right.
All right, look, finish up, do the best you can. I'll be right back. I gotta go to work, okay?
Okay. All right.
Hey y'all, Mr. Kirk here today. We will be doing a afro with the taper and a beard. Like I always say, it ain't what you do, it's how you do it. All right, so step one, you wanna comb the hair out pretty good. You wanna get a good length of what you're working with. So you wanna comb it out real good. That's why you're combing it out, so that you can get it all out, and when you're bringing it down, you can get an even cut. Step two, leveling the afro. In this case today, I will be using the 8-guard with the wall clipper. One thing that is very important, sanitizing your clippers. You have to sanitize your clippers. Let your client see you doing it. Okay, so get a good eye visual of the afro before you even start. Get a good eye visual of it. That way you can get an idea of how far you want the shape of the afro to be. So leveling the afro is very important, because I know a lot of people that do it freehand, but once they wash it or they're doing something throughout the day, it goes back into that regular form. So when you freehand it, you're not getting the inside depth of the actual cut. So you want to use your guard to get that evenly, the whole afro even. All right, y'all. So step three, we're gonna go into the taper. As I did with the leveling, I actually went up with it a little bit to start the taper off. Now we're gonna go ahead and get deep into it. Okay, so when you're doing a taper with the afro, you wanna be careful because you're going up to a higher length of hair. So you have to really take your guards and level them accordingly, because it's not like on a wavelength structure. You're actually going up to the taper, so you have to really be careful with your tapering. So now we're at step four, which is a very, very important step with the afro. And it is the wild hairs. Well, not only is it the wild hairs, it's also shaping. So you're doing wild hairs and shaping. So we've done step one, we combed it out. Step two, we've done the leveling with the guard. Step three, we've done the taper. Step four, we're at now, we're doing the wild hairs with the level. All right, everybody, we are now at step five, one of the, well, to me, the most important part of the cut, the edge up. I usually start from the back. Everybody has their own preferences of where they want to start. Me personally, I like starting from the back. Okay, so doing this step, which is the edge up, you want to get a good visual of your starting and ending. So you want to step back. If you have to step back, look at your client, look at where you want to start and where you want to end up. It's almost a visual effect. You're going to see the cut before you even do it. So now we at step six, which is going to be the razor. As you can see, it's pretty short, but we're gonna get the loose hairs, the wild hairs, and clean the face up and just put that razor work on it. Y'all, this is step seven, which is the last step of the cut. This would be the finishing touches, which would consist of getting your shears, hitting the wild hairs, doing a little taper, extra little taper, hitting the razor. So whatever you have to do to make it look complete with your finishing touches, this is the time to do it. So today, we did the afro with the taper and the chin strap. I always say, practice your craft, perfect your craft, treat your clients right, be consistent with progress, and at the end of the day, you will accomplish whatever you're trying to accomplish. Always strive for perfection. Mr. Kirk, signing off.